Want to hear something cool? There's a black hole at the center of the Milky Way, and not just any black hole, it's a supermassive black hole with more than 4.1 million times the mass of the Sun. It's right over there in the direction of Sagittarius constellation, located just 26,000 light years away. As we speak, it's in the process of tearing apart entire stars and star systems, occasionally consuming them, adding to its mass like a voracious shark. Wait, that doesn't sound cool. That sounds a little scary, right? Well, don't worry. You have absolutely nothing to worry about unless you plan to live for quadrillions of years, which I do, thanks to my future robot body. I'm ready for my singularity, Dr. Kurzweil. Is the supermassive black hole going to consume the Milky Way? If not, why not? If so, why so? The discovery of a supermassive black hole at the heart of the Milky Way, and really almost all galaxies, is one of my favorite discoveries in the field of astronomy. It's one of those insights that simultaneously answered some questions and opened up even more. Back in the 1970s, the astronomers Bruce Bailick and Robert Brown realized that there was an intense source of radio emissions coming from the very center of the Milky Way in the constellation Sagittarius. They designated it SGRA asterisk. Now the asterisk stands for exciting. Now you think I'm joking, but I'm not. For once, I'm not joking. In 2002, astronomers observed that there were stars zipping past this object like comets on elliptical paths going around the Sun. Imagine the mass of our Sun and the tremendous power that it would take to wrench a star like that around. The only objects with that much density and gravity are black holes. But in this case, a black hole with millions of times the mass of our own Sun, a supermassive black hole. With the discovery of the Milky Way's supermassive black hole, astronomers found evidence that there are black holes at the heart of every galaxy. At the same time, the discovery of supermassive black holes helped answer one of the big questions in astronomy. What are quasars? And we did a whole episode on them, but they're intensely bright objects, generating enough light that they can be seen for billions of light years away, giving off more energy than the rest of their own galaxy combined. It turns out that quasars and supermassive black holes are the same thing. Quasars are just black holes in the process of actively feeding, gobbling up so much material it piles up in an accretion disk around it. Once again, these do sound terrifying, but are we in any danger? In the short term, no. The black hole at the center of the Milky Way is 26,000 light years away. Even if it turned into a quasar and started eating stars, you wouldn't even be able to notice it from this distance. A black hole is just a concentration of mass in a very small region, which things orbit around. To give you an example, you could replace the Sun with a black hole with the exact same mass and it wouldn't change anything. I mean, we'd all freeze because there wasn't any Sun in the sky anymore, but the Earth would continue to orbit this black hole in exactly the same way for billions of years. And same goes with the black hole at the center of the Milky Way. It's not pulling in material like a vacuum cleaner. It serves as a gravitational anchor to a group of stars that orbit around it for billions of years. In order for a black hole to actually consume something, it needs to make a direct hit. To get within the event horizon, which is only about 17 times bigger than the Sun for our Milky Way supermassive black hole. If a star gets close without hitting, it gets torn apart, but still, doesn't happen very often. The problem happens when these stars interact with one another through their own gravity and mess with each other's orbits. A star that would have been happily orbiting for billions of years might get deflected into a collision course with the black hole. But again, this happens very rarely. Now, over the short term, that supermassive black hole is totally harmless, especially from out here in the galactic suburbs. But there are a few situations that might cause some problems over vast periods of time. The first panic will happen when the Milky Way collides with Andromeda in about 4 billion years. Let's call this mess Milkdromeda. Suddenly, you'll have two whole clouds of stars interacting in all kinds of ways, like an unstable blended family. Stars that would have been safe will careen past one another and be deflected down into the maw of either of the two supermassive black holes on hand. And Andromeda's black hole could be 100 million times the mass of the Sun, so it's a bigger target for stars with a death wish. Over the coming billions, trillions, and quadrillions of years, more and more galaxies will collide with Milkdromeda, bringing new supermassive black holes and more stars to the chaos. So many opportunities for mayhem. Of course, the Sun will die in about 5 billion years, so this future won't be our problem. Well, fine, with my eternal robot body, it might still be my problem. After our neighborhood is completely out of galaxies to consume, then there will just be countless eons of time for stars to interact for orbit after orbit. Some will get flung out of Milkdromeda, some will be hurled down into the black hole, and others will be safe, assuming they can avoid this fate over the Google years it'll take for the supermassive black hole to finally evaporate. That's a 1 followed by 100 zeros years. That's a really, really long time. So now I don't like those odds. For our purposes, the black hole at the heart of the Milky Way is completely and totally safe. In the lifetime of the Sun, it won't interact with us in any way or consume more than a handful of stars. But over the vast eons, it could be a different story. I hope I can be around to find out the answer. You know what does need feeding? My list of topics for episodes. So let me know your questions in the comments. In our next episode, we investigate the Lagrange points. Why are they so special? Oh, and make sure you stick around for the blooper, assuming I did in fact make any mistakes. If you enjoyed this video and want to support the creation of space and astronomy news, videos, podcasts, and more, you should join our Patreon community. There are 559 amazing patrons working with us now, funding the work we do on Universe Today. You get to see our videos ahead of time, hang out with me and the team, and see unreleased material, and we remove all the ads on Universe Today for you. And we'd like to thank George McGinn, Reinhard Heinz, Stephen Murray, and the rest of the Mandlers who support us in making great space astronomy content. Want to go in the action? Go to patreon.com/universetoday. More and more galaxies will collide with Milkdromeda. Milkdromeda. Let's go back. That's not a word. Not that Milkdromeda is a word.